Today we're going to talk about how to install the TMC2130 with SPI on the Bigtree Tech Octoprint. So I'm going to point out a couple of things real quick. We have our X stepper, our Y stepper, our Z stepper, our E0 stepper, our E1 stepper, our E2 stepper, our E3 stepper, and our E4 stepper. Now, they can be used for other things, just so you know, but the things that we have to examine, because we want to do sensorless homing as well on this, is what the actual configuration is going to be for our steppers. So in order to do that, we have to look up what it's going to be in the manual. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you first where to find it, and then we'll go from there. So inside the Bigtree Tech GitHub website, you can see there's an Octopus version that you can search on. Now, I recommend downloading it because apparently viewing it doesn't work very well at the moment. So what I did is I actually pulled it down. And as you can see in this upper corner right here, this is the enable pin that we have to find out where that is. And I'll show you how to do that in just a second. But these are the actual jumper settings. So what we're going to do is we're going to configure the jumper settings on the actual workbench over here. So what we're going to do is we're going to check to see that they're in the right slot, which they are. And we know the enable pin is going to be in the upper left-hand corner for each one of these. And the simple way to install this is you pick up their TMC2130 and you can see where the pins are. So the yellow is going to correspond with the red. So we're going to slide this in like so and apply a little bit of pressure to push it down. Now I have heat fins on this. So in this case, I'm going to show you how to actually do the cooling fans for at least the 12 volt to start and then maybe the 5 volt if we have time. So now that we have that installed, we also have to configure the diag pins over here. So what I'm going to have to do is grab an actual filament, or excuse me, not a filament, a jumper. So I'm going to put the jumper on the X diag pins right here and push it down. That way we can do sensorless homing. Now, also, when you're running the TMC drivers for steppers, you're going to remove your USB jumper that's located over here. After we have that set, we need to configure the actual firmware. So I'm going to pop out the drive and I'm going to place it in here and then into my computer. So you may hear a beep. Now, the next thing that we have to worry about is actually power. So to do this, I actually have to lift this up for you and point out that we have power over here for the steppers. So I marked one with red for voltage. Then we have our board power, which I also marked with red. So we're going to connect this up. So I'm first going to do the ground. Now I'm going to do the voltage. Now the power supply is obviously unplugged right now. Now I'm going to do the actual board logic. So I'm going to plug this one in here and tighten that down. Then I'm going to do the voltage again. So we've got that set. Now the next thing we're going to have to research after this is the actual jumper settings for the fans. So right now it's coming in the default mode. So we're going to have to go back over to the desktop for a second and look at the manual. So I'm going to scroll down here. And they have the actual fan ports. So as you can see, they're right here. So the output power, we're going to actually use the second fan port because the first one is a default. So I'm going to leave that alone for now. And I'm going to show you first, right now we're in default 24 volts. And you see how there's a jumper here and a jumper down here. And then you have your power for what they have is red being voltage and green being ground. So what we need to do is find the 12 volt section, which is right here. and it's the second jumper over. So this might be a little difficult for me to work out. So you're gonna also have to have the jumper on the second set of pins. So to do this, we're gonna go back over to the workbench. We're gonna pop out the actual jumper over here, and we're gonna move this to the middle set of pins. This will give us 24 volts. Then we're gonna pop out the actual jumper that we're using, and we're gonna place that on the actual second set of pins in the center. So it looks like we've got that in there and we're all jumped. So what I'm gonna do is I'm actually gonna jump the second one. So I'm gonna slide this over. Notice how it has a notched connector. This might be a little bit too far, but let's see if I can get it in here. There we go. So I'm gonna slide this down in here, red being over on the top part and black being on the bottom. And so we have that configured. So next thing that we need to do is actually load the firmware. So I'm gonna show you this now. So I'm gonna go back over to the desktop yet again. I'm gonna open up VS Code. Now I've made a tutorial on how to install VS Code and also the basics to compiling. That's the first tutorial in the playlist. But I'm clicking on Explorer, then I'm clicking on Open Folder. I'm going to my Downloads folder, my Marlin folder, my next Marlin folder that I had extracted when I downloaded it, and I'm gonna select the folder. This is gonna take a moment to load. It's gonna populate first with platformio.ini, and it's gonna make reference to a folder called ini, which is our board type in here someplace. But we'll figure that out in a second. So the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm actually gonna go to the Marlin folder, then the source folder, then the core folder, then boards.h. I'm gonna search on Octo, and it's gonna find the Octopus version 1.1. I'm going to copy that. Then I'm gonna close out of boards.h. I'm gonna minimize core and source. Then I'm gonna go over to configuration.h, and I'm gonna search on motherboard. Inside here, I'm going to highlight the ramps, right click, and paste what we just copied. So now that's all set, I'm gonna scroll up and I'm gonna change the serial port to -1. That'll allow us to communicate with the board over a serial connection. And now we're gonna search on our stepper driver. So it's A4988. And that brings us to the section where our steppers are. And by design, I guess now, they have them enabled for X, Y, Z, and E0. So we're working with the X stepper. So we're gonna find the 2130, we're gonna highlight it and copy it, then paste it over the A4988, and that'll set up the actual stepper for us in this case. So the next thing we need to do is go down here to default access steps per unit, and this is related to configuration.h. So I'm gonna search on 800 initially, and it's gonna take a couple of searches to get to it. And we have our X stepper. So here's the 16 micro steps. If you change or increase your steps from 80 to 160, that means that you have to increase the 16 to 32. They're proportional. So keep that in mind if you need to configure something. Next, we're going to enable TMC_debug. This will allow us to troubleshoot things. So I'm gonna remove the actual comment. Then I'm gonna search on it a second time. And this allows us to use the G code. So I'm gonna remove the comment there as well. Then I'm gonna go back up. And what I need to find here is the configuration for SPI. So this might take a moment, but it's the software that's defining where the SPI is. So use software SPI. So we're gonna remove the comment, and those relate to the pins file. Now that we have that set up, what we're gonna have to do is find sensorless homing. So I'm going to search on sensorless. And this will bring us to sensorless homing down here. I'm going to remove the comment. And what will happen is we'll now be able to set the sensitivity. Now, 8 is pretty good for SPI, which is defined here. So if you need to know what's going on, you can always focus on this and adjust where needed. They give you comments that will explain what's occurring and what you can change. So now that that's set, we're going to go back over to configuration.h for a moment, and I'm going to show you how to invert the direction just in case. So we're going to search on invert. And if your stepper is going the wrong way, what you can do down here, if it's going in the direction where your end stop once had been, you can change the false to a true or the true to a false depending upon which direction it's traveling and invert it. You can also do that by flipping the DuPont connector, which I haven't connected yet, so I'll show you that real quick. So the DuPont connector in this case can be placed this way in. If you have an issue, you can flip it in the other direction. So now that we've got that configured for the actual steppers, we need to configure the fan. So we're going to go back over to the computer for a second. And inside VS Code, we're going to go to the advanced configuration and we're going to search on controller underscore fan. And that'll bring us to use controller fan. So I'm going to remove the comment there. Then I'm going to set the pin. And this is where the pins file comes in actual handy. So keep in mind that right now it's -1, so nothing is specified. So I'm going to make one little pass over here. I'm going to go to source. Then I'm going to go to pins. And then I'm going to find our actual board type, which is the STM32F. Then in here, you can see that they have the 1.1 version, but it's making reference to this version over here. So these are our pins. So now I'm going to search on our actual pin for our fan. So I'm going to type fan, and this will bring us to our fans. Now the first one, according to the diagram for the board down here, says that the fan pin is PA8. That one didn't work too well because it won't compile. So what I discovered is use the second fan being PE5. So over here you can see where PE5 is defined as your first fan. So I'm going to copy that. Then I'm going to close out of the pins file. I'm going to go over to where it's -1 and I'm going to paste that value. The other thing I'm going to change is the actual fan speed. I'm going to change it to 200. And I'm also going to change the time after your motors are disabled for the fan to go off to 5 for the moment. So now that we've got that set, what we're going to have to do is set up the actual compile. So in this case, what I need to do is I need to go to the INI folder. So I'm going to minimize all these folders for a second. Go over to platformio.ini and show you where we need to change the default environment. Now this was related to the when you go into core source boards.h. Our file over here has STM32F. So that's what we're going to search on. So I'll minimize this real quick. And I'll go over to the INI. Then I'll find that folder STM32F. And I'll search on Octoprint. Or excuse me, Octopus. Then I'll copy it. I'll close this file out. I'll go back over to the INI and I'll paste it right here. And so we're all set there. Next thing that we want to actually focus on is actually making sure that we've cleaned up from the previous build, which comes with your download and extraction. So I'm going to click on the clean garbage can down here and that'll clean that out for us. Next, what we'll do is we'll click on the checkbox for build, which will cause a series of compiles. Now, sometimes this may fail. If it does, hit the checkbox again and see if that fixes the issue. So in this case, it did fail for me, so I'll click on the checkbox and hopefully this time it'll work. If it fails a second time, then what you'll do is you'll find the very first error that it fails on and take corrective action. So in this case, it's probably gonna compile perfectly fine, but apparently we've got an issue. So here's the issue that we've got. So I'm gonna find the very first error, and it says something about inverting the X minimum end stop. So I'm gonna highlight that, then I'm gonna copy it. I'm gonna go over to configuration.h because I know it's in here. I'm gonna do a search on that, and I'm gonna change the false over here to a true. And that should, in theory, take care of the problem. So we'll hit compile again and see if this resolves the issue. So this is a really good example of how to find issues and then correct them. So after this compiles, we're actually going to have to load it on the actual SD drive. So we can actually watch the compile up here in .pio under build for the Octopus. And you can see it filling in the folder with the things that it needs to compile with or has compiled. And in a second, we should see firmware.bin, which we do. So we're going to right-click on that, and then we're going to go to Reveal and Explorer. We're going to right-click again, and we're going to send it to our USB drive that holds the SD. So as you can see, I just copied it over, and the previous one that was loaded has a .cur. Now, while this is a cursor type file, firmware.cur in this case means current. If you wanted to use it again versus the firmware.bin, you would type this in lowercase dot bin for this. So it'd be firmware.bin. So now that we've got that solved, we're going to go back over to our actual desktop and we're going to pop out the drive. We're going to insert it in over here. And I've already removed the USB, so I'm going to plug this in and there will be no power. Next, what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to, pardon me, I just dropped my cord. I'm going to put the cord in to power it. So this will load the firmware, so you'll see some flashing. I'll move that off to the side. So now that the firmware is actually loaded, you notice how the fan is not moving. So we're going to go over to Pronterface now. So inside Pronterface, what we're going to actually do is we're going to see what's occurring with the actual stepper. So this may take a moment to bring up here for you. So here we go. As you can see, it's already on COM port 9. What you can do if you don't see it is actually go to Device Manager and search on it. But I've covered that so many times that this time I'm going to skip that. So I'm going to click Connect. As you can see, it says connecting, printer is now online. So we're going to type in M122 to test the status. As you can see, it says OK over here, so we're all set. So let's try moving the actual axis for the X-axis and watch the fan as this occurs. As you can see, the fan went on and it's continuing to work, but if you click motors off, what will occur in 5 seconds is it should turn off. Okay, so let's try homing it and seeing if sensorless homing works. So as you can see, sensorless homing works as well. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe, and thank you very much.